In today's gospel, we have this account of the rich man and Lazarus. And we see in that rich man how he has lots of comfort, how he's partying, he has the best clothes, he has lots of money and material things, and he is living his life, right? He's really living it up and enjoying it. But then this poor man, Lazarus, who is actually at his front door, right? Who's on his doorstep. He is there in desperate need. He's poor and he's suffering a lot. And he is hoping that this rich man may spare a little bit, even a few crumbs so he can eat or some things to help him. But the rich man does nothing. And because of that, after they both die, the rich man ends up in hell, but Lazarus ends up in heaven. This gospel encourages us, right? And it warns us and encourages us to make sure that we are on the lookout for those who are in need and that we are very generous, not just with ourselves. It's easy to be generous with ourselves, to rationalize, I really need this, you know, but also to be very generous with others. There's a story of a little girl who's actually a venerable. So she's on her way to sainthood. Her name is Venerable Maria del Carmen Gonzalez. And as a young girl, someone came and knocked on the door. They rang the doorbell. And she opened the door, and standing before her was a beggar. It was a poor person who said, "Can you please help me in any way? I'll take anything." So she said, "Just hold on," right? She said, "Hold on a minute." And she went into her house, and she found some money, some coins that had been lying around. She gathered them up, and she took them and gave them to the poor man. But she noticed, and she felt very sad because he was very poor. So she is very clever, right? And she had an idea, and she whispered to the man, "Now, I have an idea. We'll close the door. I'm going to go and hide. Ring the doorbell again. And this time my mom will come, and she'll give you more. And she'll give you even more," right? But what we love is that generosity of the heart of this little girl, and maybe her mom probably afterwards as well, not knowing that her daughter had already given something, that they both would want to help, right? For us here, we know there is poverty and things in our local area right here, and we are trying and we need to help in different ways. For those who come near the church on Sunday, and other times, we have our gift cards for the grocery store, and that's one way that we're trying to make sure that at least one of the basic needs of food is being met. For this parable, right, for the story of the rich man and Lazarus, I just want to point out maybe two things to reflect on as you're going home or for the rest of the Mass here. Do each of those persons have something to teach us? I think we can learn and reflect a little bit on the rich man and on Lazarus to our benefit. And so for the rich man, right, we know he's living in such comfort, he has lots of things, right? St. Basil, he writes about him, he says, "Beware of luxury, for the rich man is tormented not because of his evil deeds." And in the past, we don't really hear exactly of like him doing a mortal sin or something gravely wrong, although we are supposed to be generous, right? But he says for him, the big problem is not so much that he committed a grave mortal sin, but because of his self-indulgent life, right? His self-indulgent life, focusing on himself, had led him away from God. His self-indulgent life had turned in upon himself, his own pleasures, his own desires, all the things that he wanted he would get, and he wasn't then able to see where there was need. He wasn't able then to be generous and to reach out to others. And for us, there is a warning there, right? For all of us. For most people in the world, we would be considered very rich, very wealthy, right? All the things that we have, we might think it's not that much. But for many people in the world, they would look at us very differently. And so we want to make sure ourselves that we're not caught up in our luxury, that it's not turning us inward on ourselves, turning our lives into this self-indulgent life, but that we are very generous with others, that we are looking out and able to see where there is need so that we can offer a helping hand. And then also Lazarus, he has stuff to teach us as well, right? He is there at the foot of the door and he doesn't have food, he's homeless, and he's in pain. And just because you're poor, it doesn't mean you're a saint, right? Just because you're poor or homeless, it doesn't mean that you're super virtuous or that you've got kind of these deeper things all figured out. For some poor people, right? They can be very angry, just like us. They can be miserable. They can be sarcastic, self-centered, even greedy, right? All of these things. It's possible. Just because you're poor doesn't make you a saint. But for this man at the door, right? We don't hear him complaining. We don't hear him in anger or lashing out or sarcasm or any of these things. But he is there just hoping that the rich man might spare him some food. He is carrying his cross, we could see, very well, right? There's some things that we can't escape. There's some sufferings that we cannot get away from. And from those, we want to carry them with Christian dignity, right? We want to carry them and allow them, and they can do this, allow them to transform us, right? To allow them to help us to love more. In that suffering, to be able to love more, to give of ourselves more, to try to find God in the midst of even great suffering. It's interesting that God doesn't leave this man totally alone, but notice that some dogs come to lick his sores. And what some say is that the saliva and the licking of sores helps to give some relief and even maybe some healing, right? And so those dogs are sent as maybe as a little act of mercy from God in order to encourage and to help the poor man Lazarus. For us today, right, we want to think a lot about our own generosity, our own charity, and also our own hearts. We want to have that heart of Lazarus, who isn't afraid of suffering, but who bears it with great dignity, and who through that, he becomes a saint. He gets to go to heaven. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.